Det där var alltså Keel med Speed Demon. Och som jag nämnde tidigare på programmet så kommer vi ha en liten gäst med oss här idag på telefon. Jari Kainulainen från det nya superbandet Shadow Quest. Så att jag tar och byter språk till engelska och så drar vi igång. Hello Jari!
Hello.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you very much for joining in.
No problem. My pleasure.
Ah, great. So, first of all, how are you?
I'm fine. Like, we had a sauna evening last night and with a friend. I'm maybe a little bit tired now, but it's going to be fine. So, no problem.
Okay, that's
all good.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, I know you're from Finland, so you have a lot of sauna in Finland, right?
Yeah, pretty much everybody has sauna. Even on the block houses, they have own saunas.
Aha, okay.
it's even some hotels have like hotel rooms. In Lapland, they have like in Kemi, they have like hotel rooms and they have this two-seater saunas in the rooms.
Okay, I did not know that.
Well, that's quite nice.
Okay.
Yeah, but so must in Finland. So.
Yeah. Okay. But you live in Norway now, right?
Yeah, I moved here like in 2007. My wife is Norwegian. And then we got the kid and everything. And then came this Evergrey band.
Yeah.
I joined also 2007. So everything turned much more easier that we move here in Norway. Shorter trip to Sweden, Göteborg.
Yeah.
And our whole family is here, like most of the family. So we have lots of babysitters here.
Ah, okay.
it was somehow like a natural move.
Okay.
And it feels good, yeah.
Yeah, I've been to Norway many times. It's a very nice country.
Yeah, and cheap.
Cheap?
Yeah, not really, no.
No, that's what I thought. It's very expensive compared to Sweden, at least.
Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah.
Ridiculous sometimes.
Yeah. And how's the weather in Norway? Because up north in Sweden, it's very, very cold now and not many days left until the snow arrives. So how's the weather in Norway?
It's pretty okay. It's like a plus 8. And the trees are turning like a brownish yellow and autumn coming. But it's still like a plus 8 or plus 10.
Okay.
But at nighttime, it gets really cold. It might be zero already, but it's pretty okay because this is quite down here anyway, so it's like a more mild weather than up north.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. So.
All right. You live in the south of Norway.
Yeah, it's close to Oslo. I guess
okay.
You know where is Oslo.
Yes.
It's from the Oslo to the south, 60 kilometers.
Okay.
So it's basically Oslo area. It's a totally like a small village, countryside. 2,000 people lives here, and we are living in the middle of the field.
Okay.
Just going around here. And
okay.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Nice.
Yeah.
The list of bands you've been playing with is not only long, it's the list of successful bands such as Stradivarius, Symphonia, Masterplan, Evergrey, Mess, Kotipelto, just to mention a few. And now you're playing with this new band called Shadow Quest. What?
Yes.
What can you tell us about this band?
Shadow Quest.
Yes.
It was 2 years ago. I got mail from Ronnie Miljavodnovic, our drummer.
Yeah.
And he was asking if I'm up to playing on his project. It was project there that time, 2 years ago. And of course, I just said I was asking what kind of music it is and what kind of songs, and can you send me some files and I can check it out. And then he sent me probably four songs, and I was ooh, what the fuck, this is good stuff. So I mean, when we do recordings and where, and then he just said just come here when you're ready with the songs. It was 14 or 13 songs, if I remember right, something like that.
Yeah.
Then I was just driving to the Örebro from his studio and recording three spaces there. Oh yeah, and about this this recording, it was most one of the like the easiest process to do recordings with Ronnie.
Okay.
Somehow it was so easy and comfortable and everything. It was so nice atmosphere.
Nice.
And that's it. And then I heard there in the studio, I actually heard another guy was playing in the band also. I didn't know knew the other guys before that. That there's Peter Huss and Ragge also, and Kaspar and Patrick.
Yeah.
So that was, it just somehow clicked. I mean, it's a super good album, I have to say.
Yeah, I know it's a great lineup. We have Kaspar on the keyboards, very very fast metal keyboard player, and Patrick Johansson, also known from Dawn of Silence and Bloodbound, on vocals.
Yeah, insane voice.
Yes.
Yeah. Really, really cool. Like,
yeah,
I love it. And a great guys also, everybody.
Yeah.
So somehow it's matching. We had so much fun when we had video shootings in Örebro one weekend, and we had lots of fun, I tell you.
I can imagine. So you recorded a video for... for one song of the album.
Yeah, All One.
That song, All One, that's your single, and it's out now on iTunes, if I'm correct.
Exactly. And also, this there was some other, I don't remember now, some like a... Oh, well, it says on our website, shadowquest.se.
Yeah?
But, yeah, it's iCloud, absolutely there. Yeah, it's out.
Okay.
Now, yeah.
Yeah, that's...
And the video is also, like, out.
So you can see it on YouTube?
Yeah, and also, I guess, you can... There is a link on our home site. And
yeah?
Also, Facebook, there is a link where you can see, like, a Shadow Quest.
Okay, so it's shadowquest.se.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Okay. S-E, like a Sweden.
Yeah. So, kom ihåg det, gå in på www.shadowquest.se och kolla in hemsidan till det här nya superbandet. That song, All One, is there anything special you can tell us about that song?
maybe this will be good to ask from Patrick or who made the lyrics.
Yeah.
Actually, for me it's like a just a... I like that kind of music, and for me it's like a really... I just like... there's lots of technical stuff.
Yeah.
It's not that easy what it sounds. I don't know if it sounds easy or not. But
okay.
There's lots of playing, and I love it. I love always doing lots of playing. So it's for me, it's just a really good song. There's not any special meaning for me, but it's a killer clip. And a beautiful solo part. Absolutely. Ragan here. Insane good work with the guitars and keyboards also, Kaspar. It's just it's a great package.
You know, I think we should play that song so the listeners can hear it.
Yeah, go ahead, man.
Yeah, absolutely. So here it is, ladies and gentlemen, mina damer och herrar, för första gången på Bodens närradio, Shadow Quest med All One.
Shatter!
Det där var alltså All One med nya supergruppen Shadow Quest. Och med oss på luren har vi fortfarande Jari Kainulainen som spelar bas i Shadow Quest. And Jari, I have to tell you, that song was fantastic. It sounded great. And the production is brilliant, fantastic. You mentioned you recorded this in Örebro.
Yeah, in Ronny's studio.
Yeah, Ronny the drummer, his studio. So. Yeah. So he's the producer of the album?
Pretty much he made the songs also, like basically. And so he's like a mastermind of the band.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. It's kind of special that drummer is doing everything. It's like a rush.
Yeah. Yeah. It's not often the drummer is the songwriter in metal bands.
Yeah, it's different.
Yeah,
but it looks like it works pretty nicely.
Yes, it does. So, what about you, Jari? Are you playing with any other bands right now except Shadow Quest?
Yes, of course, Masterplan. Yeah, like we're going on a tour, like in 2 weeks, supporting Ed Guy.
Ah.
And it's a short, like 10 days.
Mm.
Yeah, like just going to like Spain and France and stuff like that, short tour, and after that, pretty much like a pretty long time. We start to do some recordings with Roland Krapov, Masterplan guitar player.
Yeah.
Some like recordings, you know, probably December or something like that.
Okay.
Then I play also Devil's Train,
where
it's playing also ex Kratovaris drummer Jörg Michael.
Ah, okay.
Playing drums, of course.
Yeah.
And then, Mr. Prophecy Finger, Leah, and guitar player Lucky Ragazzas playing guitar there. So that's more like a hard rock, like a heavy riff and rock and roll stuff, like American Hollywood stuff.
It's good to have a different kind of style in the band, so you just don't always play the same kind of music.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's we finished our like. 3 videos and new album with the Devil's Train, those coming out January or something like that. And also I have one Finnish, like a cover band. We are playing only Dio stuff, like Black Sabbath and Dio and Rainbow.
Ah, okay.
It's called Tuli Perse. It's Finnish and it means, it's in English, it's fire ass.
Fire ass?
Yeah.
Okay. what was it, Tuli Kari?
Tuli Perse.
Okay. Very hard to pronounce, but
okay.
Fire ass, very good name.
Yeah. Also, Elias from Sonata Arctica playing guitar on that band. Also, and Fratovaris drummer Rolf Pilve.
Yeah,
he's playing drums on that band also. So.
Aha, okay.
So those are the bands right now. So there's like a basically 4 bands there: like Shadow Quest, Devil's Train, Masterplan, and Tuli Perse. But yeah, but with the 3 bands. It's gonna be really busy next summer, I know that.
Okay.
But of course, that's a good thing.
Yeah, I can imagine that. Of course. And what's your main inspiration for starting to play the bass? Was it some group you heard, or a certain bass player, or how did you start to play the bass?
It started like I was playing ice hockey before that.
Okay.
And when I was 11, our friend has a party at his home, and he had a band there playing. And I was just watching, and somehow I liked the sound of the bass when I was 11.
Mm.
And after the gig, I tried the bass, and I liked it. It felt like a nice on the hand.
Yeah.
I remember. Then I used still like a pick, of course, like this.
Yeah.
My dad bought me a bass, my first bass. Actually, that was Ibanez. Also, and then it just started, and I was playing like a maniac all the time. I quit hockey because no time for that, because need to play all the time. And of course, then came like Black Sabbath and Iron Maiden, Keith Butler and Steve Harris. Those are like huge influences for me. Still, they are like, and Billy Sheehan and Cliff Burton.
Ah, Cliff Burton, yes. It was only a couple of days ago, his death day.
Yeah, it was like 28 years ago.
Yeah.
28 years ago.
Yeah.
Unbelievable how fast time is going. Yeah, but it was like that's how it started.
Okay. from hockey to Ibanez bass.
Yes.
And you still play Ibanez?
Actually, I quit with them.
Okay.
I got really, really cool offer from Grossman guitarists.
Okay.
They're like a handmade. They're doing handmade basses and guitars.
Mm-hmm.
So I got basically the same deal what I had with Ibanez, but also like a signature model. And I could choose everything what I wanted to have in those basses. Or like a wood, what kind of wood I want to have, nets, pitch nets, and how long and everything. So it was quite natural to move there. And of course, I've been with Ibanez so long. Of course, it felt a little bit bad to leave, but also nice to jump something new.
Yeah.
Change something and try something new. And everybody's been saying these Grossman guitars, they are so good. So.
Okay.
Soon we see. I'm getting my first bass, I guess, in a few weeks now. So it should be ready.
Okay. And how many strings?
Six, of course. I don't know even how to play with the four or five. I've been playing 30 years with the six strings.
Okay. Yeah, because I've seen throughout your whole career, I've only seen you play like six strings basses. So.
Yeah, somehow I like the neck wider. And all like you don't need to jump that much around when you have like six strings. You can play like difficult scales with short area, so you don't need to jump up and down. And I think sound is better because it's wider neck, so the sustain the bass. The sound is much more powerful than a thinner neck.
Okay.
But that's my opinion.
Yeah.
Okay. It might be different. Huh? But that's pretty much the reason, and it just feels good on a hand.
Hmm? All right, cool.
Yeah.
And I hope your signature bass is as good as you hope it will be.
Yeah, I really hope so.
Yeah.
I think so. At least it looks good.
Okay, yeah, of course. you know, we're sending this radio up north in Sweden, in Boden, and you've been here before, right?
I think so. Maybe a bit Evergrey.
Around 2010, maybe.
Yeah, I think so. We had this Swedish tour with a little van, and we were driving around the Sweden. Yeah, I think we were there.
Yeah, it was a Swedish a festival here in Boden called Nordic Rage Metal Festival. Other bands who played were The Haunted, for example.
Yes, now I remember. Yeah, exactly. It was like a wooden big house.
Yes, it was at a place called Western Farm outside of Boden.
Yeah, I remember. It was a really nice place, by the way. There was brilliant food and everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there was one belly dancer also, if I remember right.
Yes, there were. There were belly dancers.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, that was great.
Yeah, cool. you know, Jari, I have to thank you very much for joining into this interview. It's been a true honor. But before we say goodbye, I have to ask you, do you have any song request that you would like me to play here in this radio show?
Yeah, of course, there's so many. And if I need to pick up one,
yes,
what I would listen right now, it's Black Sabbath, Heaven and Hell.
Good choice.
My choice. That's my choice.
Okay.
Killer album, killer songs, and killer vocalists.
Yeah, Ronnie James Dio.
Yes.
Yes.
Rest in peace.
Yeah, of course. I will fix that for you. So,
all right.
Yeah, Jari, thank you very much. And
thank you.
And now, Heaven and Hell, med Black Sabbath.